Ruby on Rails 7 is out. Code along on a guided journey through the Rails 7 Getting Started Guide and beyond with test-driven development. There has never been a better time to learn Ruby on Rails. Hit the ground running with the newest version. Go to statelesscode.com/getting-started-with-rails-7 to level up. Welcome to this Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 21 in our series, statelesscode.com WordPress. And so, last few videos we've been working on getting the sidebar in order. One of the things that this is a production issue that I'm just going to knock out hopefully quickly. So the picture on the about page of the real statelesscode.com right now, you can see that this, if I were to do a full page refresh, I think it'll take a while to, or if I were to clear my cache, it takes a long time to load that resource because the picture file is 6.5 megabytes or something like that. So it is kind of prohibitively large for the size that the picture is actually displaying as, even on a large screen. So I'm going to take that into GIMP and resize it and modify that file in the about page. So let me get GIMP over here. I'll open the pause and open the file. All right, so we've got the file. It is ginormous. It is 3,000 by 2,000. So yeah, I don't need it that big for this use case. So we're going to image. I can probably even crop this slightly. Selection, and then scale image, and I think I can get away with 25% here. Maybe 33%. That's about the size that it's displaying on the, it's a little bit bigger, so, but I think that's good enough. We will export this as a PNG. Into the about page on the dashboard. We'll edit it. So for this, keep my caption just in case I replace upload. So we've got it here. I can still go medium here. And medium is what I want. Update that. View page. Yeah, that seems to run a lot faster. I might need to clear my cache here. Oh, we can see it shows up right away after I do that, which is good. So we can go into our backlog, move that to done. Now the sidebar is not showing up on the individual post page. That is our next thing to tackle. And hopefully will be fairly innocuous if I can find the right place to handle the layout. So we'll look at our layouts and then single. So we get parcels, content, single. Header, entry content, footer. Comments template. So I might just need to look at the what I'm getting for a footer, if anything, here. So the normal footer is showing up. Comments template is something we'll deal with later. But we've got no sidebar at all. So the footer essentially yielding that article, and this is the article footer, not the site footer. So index has sidebar. Page does not. Single does not. So I think I can, I copy this to here. Fingers crossed. Booyah! All right, so that is solved. Now, I want that on some of my pages, but not all of them. So, page. Extends layouts. I've got the content section. And then for some pages, but not all, I want the sidebar. How would I control that? All right, so for about, it has template, default template. this is my local here. And then for where are my pages? All pages. Then let's say home. I want to use custom template. Update that. So now, I don't think it's going to change anything yet. But if I go to about, got page, no sidebar. And then home, got the page, no sidebar. Now I'm going to change the default page. Like we did with single, to include the sidebar section. And I expect that this would show up on the about page now, but not the home page. So home, no sidebar. About, sidebar. So that gives me what I want. Let me take a look at the backlog. So I think that one's done there. While we're in here, I think I'm also going to, well, let's commit that as a unit of work. Write my commit message. All right, there's our message. Push. Move this to done. And then post title headings are too big. So we'll look at that now. So this is for most of our, I think it's our H1. So if we go to our overall index here, latest posts, like the post titles here aren't too big. It's maybe it's just on single that that these H1s are so like when you've got a long title on a post, which it's not the best thing to have a long title on a post, but it happens sometimes. I mean, that takes up a good portion of your screen. The yeah, I think we can go. Let's at least, before we do that, see, that's even big on mobile. Yeah, so our H1s are that's main article header H1 that is just ginormous. So let's go into our here. Is that structure predictable? H1. So I think if we can go main H1. That'll give us what we need there. So right now, if we go and look at this, it is font size is 2.66667 em. All right, so we're here on the tailwind. So this is like 4XL right now. Between 4XL and 5XL. So maybe if we can just get down to like, I don't know, we'll try. We'll try 3XL and see how that looks. Let it compile. All right. So that didn't change anything. Make sure it compiled, or I'll just play around with it in the playground here. Take our long title as the example here. That is about what we were saying before. 3XL, 4XL. I think 3XL is what we're seeing in the it's roughly the size of what we're seeing there. So maybe a 4XL will says we built successfully. Let's go back here. Yeah, it's still not changing that side. It's like there's an important directive or something there. Entry title. Is entry title a tailwind class? Nope. Is that always? No, the class is page header there. is this not? What if I just go in the debugger and add that class there? It's not getting applied here. Even when I, am I using the right class here? Font size. Seems like it reacted to the, let me explicitly copy and paste the exact it's not doing anything here. Where's that 2.6667 coming from? All right, I'm going to see if just doing it here will do anything. Made it even larger. All right, but it did something. Oh, because I put it in the wrong place. Try it again. There. I can get away with 3XL. Let's take that out of the CSS. Latest posts, my about page, my home page, yeah, still going to 2.0. And why is that? Being compiled like that. Let's see if that does anything. Oh, I've got an error now. Oh, because I need to put the nested stuff before the apply. Did that give me anything? There we go. Okay. Let's go back to home. So we can make that, I think 4x is probably good. That's reasonable. We can live with that. Let us write our commit message. All right, get our message, make sure all of our saved items are closed. Take our backlog item, move it to done, and see you next time.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding. And don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.